my fellow Americans, ask not what your country can do for you. Ask what you can do for your country.
It is these words that remain how I remember John F. Kennedy and what has caused a visible change in America since his assassination as well as during his life. Though these words are those that have been contributed to Kennedy since his time, we must ask ourselves what these words actually mean. Through Kennedy's own time as president of the US, but even more so after his death through his legacy, he has truly accomplished what he set out to do as president, which was to encourage others to give back to their country as well as the whole entire world. Taking a bit more of a closer look at the key things to which we remember JFK today, it is easy to see that his actions, as well as his words and legacy, truly reflected his message of contributing to society on a grand scale.
The energy, the faith, the devotion which we bring to this endeavor will light our country and all who serve it. And the glow from that fire can truly light the world.
The Profiles in Courage Award is an award that was started by Carolyn Kennedy, the daughter of John F. Kennedy. Carolyn's influence to start this award was to honor those who had truly set out in the world to give back to society as her father had wanted others to do so. It was named after the book written by John F. Kennedy, which explained how to demonstrate courageous qualities in our own lives. The one thing that sets this award out from others is that it is given to those who have placed their jobs on the line and even their own lives to work for the better of national, state, or even local visions. This award has been given to such people as Sergeant Joseph Darby, who told the government about the torture and prisoner abuse going on in Abu Ghraib. The award was also given to the first responders of the 9/11 terrorist attacks, like firefighters and the military, who acted as representatives of all of those who saved lives in the World Trade Center. In an interview with Carolyn Kennedy after Hurricane Katrina, she puts it best as to who the award is usually given to.
Well, my father transformed the idea of public service for a generation, and we really think that the best way of commemorating his life is to celebrate that kind of commitment today. And I think each year we look for people who have stepped forward and done something well beyond what the rest of us were thinking.
The Profile in Courage Award is the best way to remember exactly what John F. Kennedy wanted us to do in the world, as set by examples of those who have received this award, especially the 9/11 first responders. It is one of the best ways to continue Kennedy's legacy and message to all the future generations of America.
A struggle against the common enemies of man, tyranny, poverty, disease, and war itself. Can we forge against these enemies a grand and global alliance, north and south, east and west, that can assure a more fruitful life for all mankind? Will you join in that historic effort? Heavy burden.
One of the things that Kennedy encouraged was for all of us to join in the, quote, historic effort to rid the world of the things that had become problems to the world, especially in other countries. As a part of this effort, he created the Peace Corps. The Peace Corps was officially started on March 1, 1961. Not only was this a way to give back to the world what America had been so blessed with, but it was a means to get rid of the perceived notions of Americans and how they only cared about themselves. The main mission of the Peace Corps, as described by themselves, is, quote, to promote world peace and friendship through a Peace Corps, which shall make available to interested countries and areas men and women of the United States qualified for service abroad and willing to serve, under conditions of hardship if necessary, to help the peoples of such countries and areas in meeting their needs for trained manpower, end quote. After its creation, a first group of volunteers set out to begin their work in Ghana and Tanzania. Ever since then, the Peace Corps has continued to grow, and since its creation, more than 187,000 people have served as volunteers in 139 countries. In an advertisement for the Peace Corps, John F. Kennedy gives his own explanation on what exactly the mission and motivation of the Peace Corps is.
Our Peace Corps, I want to emphasize, is not designed as a weapon of propaganda. is not designed as a tool in the Cold War. It is a genuine effort by the people of the United States, particularly those who are young, to play their part in working for peace, in improving the lives of all mankind.
One aspect of the JFK legacy that has continued throughout history since his passing is the importance of volunteerism. Volunteerism has been one of the notable accomplishments of Americans based on our own reactions to crises around the world. Some of these have been the terrorist attacks of 9/11 and how all the New Yorkers, firefighters, as well as many others, helped save lives and clean up Ground Zero. Americans even helped out those involved in Hurricane Katrina and the tsunami in Indonesia. It is quite clear that JFK's message to help others, not only nationally but globally, has stayed with Americans to this day. So though JFK never quite got the chance to prove himself to all of America, as well as the world, because of his assassination, it is clear that he did make an effort to give back to the world, and he most definitely encouraged Americans everywhere to actively participate in these kinds of activities. After his death, it was clear that the messages and words spoken during his inaugural address spoke a truth to Americans in that we all need to make an effort to give back to society and the world.
But knowing that here on earth, God's work must truly be our own.
John F. Kennedy truly made himself a role model to all Americans, and his life works, messages, and his legacy have truly turned politics into a noble profession, and the message of which he spoke of still stays true to today and is an example of what we should all lead our lives by.